Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir, again with the new Shopify how-to video. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how you can add infinite scroll to your collection page. So if your collection page have a lot of products and you want to get rid of the pagination thing and want to add in the feature where a visitor scroll down and the product will be displayed automatically, rather than pushing the user to click on the pagination and then move on to the next page. So if you want to learn this, how to implement, stick to the video. Don't forget to subscribe the channel because I'll provide you step-by-step instructions on how you can do that without any coding knowledge. I'll walk you through which code you need to copy and paste on the files. Also, please press the thumbs up icon because that will help me understand what more content you would like to see in this channel. So without further ado, let's jump into the screen. So guys, I have all product collection in my store where I have 32 products. And when I scroll down to this collection page, you can see that I have pagination showing up and my store is showing 16 products per collection. I can show maximum 24 products if I go and change the settings in customized settings in online store editor, but I cannot display, like, if, for example, if I have 100 products or if I have more than 24 products, I won't be able to display those products on my collection page without pagination. But after following this tutorial and implementing this, you will have your collection page like this. So I have 32 products in this collection page. And when I scroll down, it automatically keeps showing all of the products and it shows complete products which are in that specific collection. Cool, right? So let's start implementing that. And that's the blog post with all of the instructions which you need to follow step by step. So there are 5 steps which we'll be following in order to implement this functionality. Okay, now let's first go to the back end of my store and I'm gonna add in new DOM theme, fresh DOM theme in front of you guys to show you that we'll be implementing it on the latest version. Okay, so that's the dashboard of Shopify. Click on online store. And from online store, I'm going to add in a new DOM theme. So that's the DOM theme. Click on add button here. And now it's installing my theme. Okay, my theme has been installed. And now I'm going to publish this theme by clicking on publish button. Click on publish button again. And now we have our fresh DOM theme published. And now let's click on these 3 small dots and preview the theme. I'm going to close the old tabs. And now when I click on all products, which has all of the products of my store, and the total number of products are 32. And now when I scroll down, you can see that it's displaying 16 products per page. Okay, now let's start implementing our tutorial where you can see all of the instructions. So first of all, download Scrollify from here. So I have already linked it. So just click on this button, click on this text, which will take you to this Scrollify website. And from there, download the Scrollify minify.js. And I have already downloaded that. So I'm just gonna include that and move on to the second step, which is including Scrollify in my main-collection-product-grid. After downloading, you also need to upload that to your asset folder. So let's upload that. Now go to themes and from the themes, click on these 3 small dots and then edit code. I keep repeating that, but it's for your own safety. Before editing your code, make sure to have a duplicate of your theme so you can easily revert it back. Cool. Now click on edit code. And from there, I'll scroll down to my assets folder. And I'm going to click on add a new asset to upload the file which I downloaded in step 1. Click on add file. And here's my ejectinate main.js. So remember, once you download that, there will be a zip folder, which you'll have to unzip first and upload ajaxinate.minify.js file. Okay. Now my JS file, my JS library for infinite scroll has been uploaded. Now the second step is to include this in main-collection-product-grid.liquid. I'm going to search that file in my code files. Here we are. And in this file, we just need to copy this code, which I have provided. So just copy it and paste it here. You can add it on top as well. It doesn't really matter. Now click on save and go back to the instruction tutorial. And now we need to add the script code before our schema in main-collection-product-grid.liquid file. Okay, now I'm going to search for schema and paste the code. Copy it from here, paste it, and hit save. Okay, move on to the next step, which is changing code in pagination.liquid file. Now search for pagination. That's my file. Click on that. And in here, I'll search for this code. So search for if paginate.next. And below this code, there will be an li where we will add this class, CSS class. Okay. Now let's search for So that's the code. It's currently on line number 60, but you don't need to worry about the line numbers. You just need to search for if pagination.next, right? Now you can see li below that. Now we will add the class. So just copy it from here. I've highlighted the code in red. Just copy the code and paste. Once pasted, it's saved. After saving the file, we'll move on to the next step, fourth step, which is adding following JS code in our facet.js file. Okay. Now search for facet.js file. Here it is, facets.js. And now let's search for this. Okay, so that's the function where you will need to add in a few more lines from here. So just copy it and paste. And hit save. Cool. One thing to note, it's not facet.js, it's facets.js. So that's the proper spelling of the file, as you can see here, right? Make sure to add in the code by searching this function and add in the code below it as per the instruction tutorial. I'll update the blog post once the video is completely recorded. Now, final step is to add the CSS code in component-pagination.css file. I'm going to search for component-pagination.css and I'm going to scroll down to the bottom. Copy the CSS code from here and paste it to my CSS file and hit save. Okay, we have successfully implemented all of the instructions provided in the tutorial. And now I'm going to preview my store and click on all products. And now scroll down. Now you can see that products are displaying up automatically and we don't have any pagination. So all of the products are showing up without any pagination. If you go to customize settings of Shopify where you have an option to change the number of products displayed in single page, you can see that we cannot display more than 24 products. So I'm going to go to online store. So from online store, click on customize. And here I'll search for collection, default collection. And now in here, when I click on product grid, you can see that I have option to change the products per page. I can change number of products displayed in a collection per page, but I cannot display more than 24 products, right? And it will keep showing the pagination when customers scroll down to the bottom of the collection page. But after implementing this tutorial, you'll have it automatically displaying. So users just need to scroll down to your collection page and product will automatically be showing up without needing them to push the navigation button. Cool, right? So if you like the tutorial, comment on the video below and let me know what more you would like to learn. Until next video, have a great day.